Now we're going to show you how to populate a bar chart using Excel, using the visual data tools. To set a scene up here, what we're going to do first is use a font to see if we are actually receiving data from our DataPool plugin. So I'm just going to scale this font down here and reposition it out of the way for us just to see once we set up our DataPool here. I'm going to add another group here a while, and we're going to go into our built-ins, into the container plugins, into the data folder. First, I'm going to drag a data reader plugin onto that new group we just drug in there. So if you want to rename this to data reader or whatever you want, this one up here is just going to be our test. So I'm going to use a data text on this container. I'm going to click on that data text to go into the data text editor. And within the field name here, I'm going to type in reader underscore console. And this will help us tell if we are getting the proper data from DataPool. And you can see a change. So the data reader is working. We're going to click on this data reader. And now we need to set up our Excel sheet. So within our hard drive, we have an Excel sheet here. So we'll go ahead and open that up. Within this Excel sheet, you can see that we have titles going across here, so we'll need to know some of those things. We have a couple of columns as well with numbers in it. There's a couple of sheets within this Excel sheet. We'll need to know the sheet that we're working in or the tab that we're working in, and we'll also need to know the specific name of the Excel sheet and the file path. So we're going to go ahead and close that, and if you want to find the file path or get the file path of your Excel sheet, you can right click and do the properties thing and just copy it right here rather than typing it out. So we go back into our DataPool reader, and here we have our query type set to Excel. We have our file name, which we are going to type in and or paste in the complete file name path. And now we need the name of our Excel sheet, which is class2.xlsm. We also need the tablet sheet name, which was stock. We also need to know the key, which is the upper left variable, the topmost upper left one. And now we also need to know which column or field we want to read. In this case, we're going to use price, and we're just going to leave this as is for the moment. The next thing we want to do is go into our built-ins, into the geometry plugins, and drag our bar chart into here. We're going to jump back into our data reader, and what we want to do next is give it a DP field name. We can give it anything we want. I'm just going to keep it simple and consistent with the last tutorial and call it var, V-A-R. Now, we want to change what type of data this is. This is no longer a data table. We're using shared memory in this case. So I'm going to change that to shared memory, and the shared memory type here is scene. So I'm going to click and make sure that scene is active. We have a fields delimiter, which I'm going to eliminate because we don't need that. And we have a rows delimiter, which I'm going to change to comma because we're going to go into our bar chart here and make sure that our data delimiter is set to comma as well. Now up here in our bar chart editor, we need to change our shared memory from inactive to scene. And we need to change our key data to match up with what we typed in our data reader, which was var. So we're going to come in here and type in var. And you can see when we do that, that this auto populates our bars here. So if we want to position this over, we can kind of see what's happening. Now let's go into the bar plugin editor. And now that we have these data, you can start playing with some of the different values in here. As we mentioned, if you click on the I button in the upper right of the editor, it will tell you exactly what each one of these options does. But you can tell, since we have so many data points here, that we would obviously need to change the width of our bar data here. So we can use that with our chart width, our bar width settings. And again, we could keyframe this on. So if we wanted all of this to animate on, what we would do is just reverse one of our stop or start percentage points here. We could set a keyframe and then have this advance up to the place where we want it and just set the keyframe again. And when we hit play, our bar data will now animate on. Now, we closed our Excel sheet. This won't work with the Excel sheet is open. So if you need to change the data, you could go into the Excel sheet, open it up, change the data, and then resave it. You can make more design enhancements, obviously, if you wanted to add a material to it, and or you could add textures to these bars as well. So you could come in and add an image to it, and or, you know, do any type of design that you need to once you have the data set within these bars. So that's how you send Excel data to the bar chart and visual data tools.